En hallo iedereen, welkom bij een nieuwe aflevering van Dead Frontier Outbreak. En we moesten nu tegen die gozer vertellen wat we aan het doen waren. Nou, we kunnen tegen hun zeggen dat ik hier ben om hun te redden. Nou, ten eerste, hoe de fuck moet ik nou weten hoe zij hier zo zitten? Dus, dan weet ze al dat ik ga liegen. Looking for food and ammo. Nou, dus ze zullen eigenlijk nog best wel raar opkijken als ik met antibiotica wegga. Dus, ik vertel ze wel van de missie. If I told the survivors the truth from the beginning. They'd probably find out sooner or later anyway. As I put my clothes back on and picked up my equipment, I explained all about the fortified farm, the disease that plagued my family, and my quest for antibiotics. Okay. They seemed impressed by my bravery and allowed me to join them on the second floor.
That is mooi.
As I climbed the escalator, I realized just how wise my decision to surrender had been. There were at least 20 survivors in the building, with over half of them armed with shotguns or rifles. The rest had an assortment of vicious-looking melee weapons. As soon as I reached the top, I was directed toward their leader, a tall and muscular African-American who introduced himself as
Ox. Wat zei ik in de vorige episode? African-American.
Ox told me that if I wanted his help and protection, or at least to be allowed to roam his mall freely, I had to earn it. Apparently there was no longer any power in the mall. And he wanted someone to head down to the basement and turn on the generator. The last man he sent never came back.
Ikke! Nou ja, ik kan wel voor extra equipment vragen. Maar ik weet niet hoe het afloopt. Nou dus, reviews. Het is een African-American. Zoals ze in de film zijn, zijn ze zo van, oh je luistert nu naar mij, bam, dood. Dus dat gaan we maar niet doen. Dus ik vraag wel voor extra equipment.
I told him I'd be happy to help, but that I desperately needed some more equipment if I was going to survive. He grudgingly agreed and got one of his
lackeys
to hand over some ammo. I was then informed that I'd be taking a mechanic named Smith along with me. Partly to fix the generator if it needed it, and partly to make sure I didn't try anything stupid.
Okay, that's mooi.
Smith and I went back down the escalator and through the door I had originally come through to the stairwell. We headed back down, and then Smith pointed out another doorway hidden under the stairs that I hadn't noticed before.
Okay. We kunnen Smith laten doen, maar ik heb de shotgun, dus ik open de
I carefully opened the door with my gun at the ready.
Bam!
Ox obviously thought this place was dangerous, so I kept my guard up.
Okay, that's mooi.
On the other side of the door, it was pitch black. If there were any windows, they were small, and the curtains or blinds were closed. We listened carefully for any signs of the infected, but heard nothing.
Okay, we kunnen teruggaan in de doorsvinder en ook de curtains. Dat zou ook niet werken, want ja, die windows zijn heel erg klein, om zo te zeggen. Een match. Ja, we zitten wel ergens bij iets wat hoog met gasdruk is, dus we kunnen best
doorsvinden. We're about to get eaten in the dark. So I told Smith to wait while I went and found a torch. The rest of the area had been a storeroom after all.
Okay.
So I hoped there might just be a torch tucked away somewhere. I was in luck. The torch was small, but it offered enough illumination for us to see our way to the generator.
Nice.
We reached the generator.
Goeie beslissing,
Smith promptly pulled a lever and pressed a few buttons. Apparently getting the thing up and running was as simple as that. Because it immediately sprang to life. The lights in the room flashed and came on, and just in time. Our activities had disturbed a small group of infected who had been lurking in a side room, and they were now rushing toward us. I opened fire and was easily able to gun the bastards down. I breathed a sigh of relief and turned to Smith, but to my horror he was lying on the floor, bleeding heavily. In the confusion I had accidentally shot him in the leg.
Nou, we kunnen hem neerschieten, maar dat doen we niet. Want dus dan schiet die Afro-Amerikaan weer op mij. We kunnen hem laten doodgaan hier, maar dus dan wordt hij volgens mij weer een zombie. En ja, dit kunnen we ook doen, maar ik denk wel dat ik de first aid kit
heb. Didn't have a lot of time, so I quickly removed the first aid kit from my backpack and got to work.
Okay.
I used a tourniquet to staunch the bleeding and then bandaged the wound. It wasn't much, but it was the best I could do. I helped him to his feet, and we headed back to the group.
Okay.
When we reached the stairwell, we were greeted by a terrifying noise. All the gunfire heard was a
Now the bright lights of the mall had attracted a large group of infected who were trying to get in any way they could.
Zie je?
My earlier efforts to barricade the building had slowed the infected down, but not nearly enough. A few of them had already made their way inside, and once again, I was forced to fight for my life. I was only just able to gun them down, and knew that soon, many more would get in.
Okay, next.
By the time we got back to the group, they were already celebrating. Now the power was back on, and they were focused on making the most of it while it lasted. Several had gotten one of the coffee shops up and running and were busy preparing hot food and drinks. Others were setting up a games console to entertain themselves while not on guard duty. Knowing about the threat from downstairs, it wasn't particularly reassuring. Smitch had lost a lot of blood and was barely conscious when we arrived.
Okay.
Once I told them he had been shot, not bitten, Ox ordered some of the few women among the survivors to take care of him.
Okay. We kunnen nog wel waarschuwen, dus dat lijkt nog wel best maar een S for real life. Nou, dat niet, want ik heb hem neergeschoten, dus ik heb ze van... Hey, ik heb hem mooi in zijn been geschoten, ik wil wat! Nou, dat klinkt echt zoiets van, nee, dat doen we gewoon niet. Cup of coffee, nee, ik...
There was no time to relax. The infected would be inside very soon. Okay. And if we weren't prepared, we'd be overrun in minutes. Before I could even finish explaining the situation, Ox was barking orders at his men, getting them into the best position to deal with the threat. Nice. They were only just in time.
Oh, fucking
suddenly,
hell,
the basement door burst open, and a seemingly unstoppable horde of infected zombies charged through. The first wave was gunned down before they reached the escalator, but more and more of them just kept on coming. Every gun in the building was blazing while survivors armed with clubs and axes struggled to keep the tide of monsters from climbing the stairs. I had no idea if we'd be able to fight them off or not.
Nu. Ik denk dat ik het beste hier zo weg kan, want dus dan help ik ze ook nog, omdat dus een paar van die geïnfecteerden ook nog achter mij aangaan.
I knew there was no way we'd be able to fight off the infected horde. My thoughts turned immediately towards saving myself. I remembered that there was a fire escape on the third floor, which would take me to the roof of the multi-story car park. While the others fought for their lives, I ran upstairs, out the door, and to the relative safety of the roof.
Okay, what now?
I stepped out into the open air and breathed a sigh of relief. I was on the top level of a multi-story car park which seemed to be blessedly free of zombies. There were also plenty of parked cars in relatively good condition, perfect for a swift and safe ride home. I suddenly noticed movement out of the corner of my eye. I span round and took aim, expecting it to be one of the infected. To my relief and surprise, it was a handful of survivors who had managed to escape the carnage downstairs.
Okay.
Before I could meet up with them, something leaped at me from the shadows, knocking my gun from my hands and nearly pushing me to the floor. I regained my balance just in time to defend myself from the creature's next assault.
I
grabbed it by the neck with both hands. Realizing he'd be unable to bite me, I pushed him back with all my might, forcing him toward the railing.
Was a zombie. Good.
It took every ounce of strength that I had remaining, but I managed to shove the infected bastard over the edge. A few seconds later, I heard a sickening splat as his body hit the ground.
Nice.
Now that the immediate danger had been dealt with, I had to decide how best to get back to the ground floor. As I picked up my gun, I took another look around. There were plenty of parked cars that I could steal, and the other survivors had already begun hot-wiring an SUV.
Wat we kunnen best doen, ik denk dat we, zoals ik al in de eerste aflevering zei, dat ik in de auto ga, en dan zit er een zombie in. Okay, join the other survivors, lijkt me ook niet best. Walk down, ook niet, dus upside down the building.
I took the rope from my backpack and securely tied it around the railing on the edge of the building. I lowered myself over the edge and began to carefully climb down. As I got to the bottom, I realized that I had made a serious mistake.
Good.
The rope I had didn't reach all the way to the ground, and I was forced to jump the last 10 feet. I landed awkwardly and broke the ankle of my right leg. It was incredibly painful.
Fuck.
But worse still was the knowing that now I'd never make it home. I tried my best to crawl as far as I could, but it wasn't long before the infected found me.
Ja, ik ben dood. Oké. Ja, dus we hebben deze gedaan. Next. Oké, okay, join the others. Wat gebeurt er nu? Oké, we could have escaped on foot. Ja,
yep, mooi. I sped out of the car park, breaking through the wooden barrier and skidding out onto the main road. I chose the most direct route I could think of, back toward the compound, and drove as fast as I could. I didn't get far, though. Not more than 2 blocks down the street, I came across the remains of a serious traffic accident. Several vehicles blockaded the road.
Good. Nee, weet je wat? Ik ga wel met de voet verder.
I couldn't see how we would get any further in the car, so we resolved to complete our journey on foot. The others seemed reluctant to leave the vehicle, but without somewhere to go, they had no reason to drive off on their own. We climbed over the crashed cars and began the long walk home.
Okay.
We didn't get far. A few blocks down the road.
Good. Ja, die had ik gedaan. Next. Stil elkaar dan. Oké, spread out park. Oké, I can think a bit. No more than 2 blocks down the street to come. Second traffic accident. Shout out to
me.
Oké.
As I look
clear. Realize make my escape might not be easy. Accelerate and run the bastards over.
I put my foot on the gas and accelerated directly into the crowd.
Okay.
The first few bodies I hit bounced off the windshield and rolled clean over the vehicle, leaving only a few large cracks and blood splats as evidence of their demise.
Come up.
As I mowed down more and more of them, I began to lose speed dramatically.
Good.
Body
Ik ben dood. Okay, next. Steal a car. Next. Shunt him.
Just
don't turn off down back.
I wasn't go.
The suicidal. Finally made it out of the town, countryside. Ready. Okay, wait, what about?
I knew I had.
Okay, as soon as the gates. Oh ja, ik heb geen medicijn. Ah, kut. Nou ja. Dus dan ga ik weer helemaal weer terug in de volgende aflevering. Totdat ik weer bij die ding ben. Dus dan pak die antibiotica en al dat soort shit. Dus ik zie je gewoon weer in de volgende aflevering. Aju!